क्लास 161 मीन्स 36 ऑफ मैकेट्रॉनिक्स सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग. यू नो द ट्रांसड्यूसर आउटपुट हैज टू बी कंडीशनड. द टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसड्यूसर्स हैव बीन स्टडीड इन चैप्टर 2. नाउ वी विल स्टडी द नेक्स्ट स्टेज, सिग्नल कंडीशनिंग एंड देन डेटा एक्विजिशन. How data will be taken inside to the processor or the next stage. Then how data can be presented, either display or recorder. So general block diagram. In your measurement system, you had studied only about measuring instruments, not of physical input. Okay. Like pressure, temperature, humidity, etc. You had studied only mainly about ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, energy meter, and frequency meter to measure electrical quantity only. Here we are going to discuss measurement system of any quantity. Right. Now the transducer senses the input and converts it into some electrical form, because we are now onwards we are dealing with electrical transducers. Then the signal conditioner conditions it such that this signal will be useful for the next stage. So here you will get what is called as modified signals. Okay, now why signal conditioning is required? What is signal conditioning and what all it does? All these things are explained here in step by step, which are very easy. If you have to read 2-3 times, that's all. So signal conditioning means you are modifying the output signals into usable form by amplification or attenuation. If the signal is less, you have to amplify. If the signal is too high, then this may get damaged. If signal is less and this tries to absorb more signal, this may get damaged. So you may need to amplify or attenuate. Okay, attenuate means decrease the level. Amplification means increase the level. And sometimes the output may not be linear. You may have to linear it. And at the output, you may have to non-linear it once again. So at the output, you may need non-linearization. Okay. Signal conditioning happens at input as well as output. You have studied in the block diagram in the first chapter. Input signal conditioning and output signal conditioning blocks. And you may need filtering, means to select only some part of frequency, or you may need to select only DC part, or isolation you may need. And also sometimes you need excitation, means you need, for passive transducers, you need external power supply, which may be DC or AC. Okay, then you may need to give some protection also. So all these things are there, which are mentioned here. Okay, see, first is what is signal conditioning, second is why it is necessary, third is what all processes are employed in signal conditioning. First is like, why should you cook food? Okay, we need food because we have to eat and we have to become healthy, etc., etc. Okay, first is what is food? Okay, then why food is necessary? Then what are the process adopted in cooking? This is like that. So protection, and then analog to digital, digital to analog conversion is done there, getting right level of signals, and then okay, these things are there. and then elimination of interference. These things are there. And again, manipulation of signals. So, how cooking is done means how these things are done by all these things. Now, functions of signal conditioning equipment means how should be your knife, how should be your gas stove, how it should be your vessels, pressure cooker or pot, etc., etc. These things are put in this topic. So, functions of signal conditioning equipment. It should be able to amplify, it should be able to modulate, means all these things. Impedance matching to get high level amplitude, that is, you know, maximum power transfer theorem. For that to happen, impedance should match. So, your cooking equipment or the signal conditioning equipment here should have that capacity. Should be able to process the data, arithmetic or logical operation. Okay, here actually arithmetic only, mainly, because that will be done here, or logical will be done in the microprocessor only. So, only a mathematical. Okay. Next, data transmission from one location to another location also you have to do that. Suppose say the transducer is at say something in the furnace, and measurement unit is in the control room. So from there to here it may be 10-20 meters or sometimes even 1 furlong also. In such case you need to transmit the signal from here to there. So while traveling from here to there itself, there will be loss. So sometimes the signal conditioning equipment will simply do the transmission from one place to another place without loss of data, means without distortion. Okay, so transmission that also is necessary. So in general, the signal conditioning equipment, okay, it should have these three things. So what we have to do is the person who designs, okay, should take care of ingenuity, means you should work as pure faithful reproduction of signal you should get proper. So for that you have to select proper components, good quality. Suppose say for filter you have to use right value of capacitance, inductance, resistance, etc. And then if you are using resistance, else only LC filter. And then for faithful reproduction of signal should be achieved. Okay, fine.